Sadly, the Star Wars Battlefront 2 beta is over, and EA is now tearing the results apart and addressing fan concerns. Specifically, it's addressing problems with its loot box economy. A lot of people who tried out the beta felt that loot boxes were pay to win. If you spent enough real-world cash, you could put yourself at a huge advantage over a similarly skilled player who doesn't have that kind of money to burn. Yeah. To counter this seductive shift to the dark side, EA said the game's most powerful items won't be locked in loot crates, but instead will be unlocked through player achievements. Star cards and weapons upgrades will also be tied to a player's rank, which means if you want to get good, you need to put in the work. A new trailer for The New Mutants dropped, and just in time for this second spookiest day of October. If you didn't know you were watching a trailer for an X-Men movie, you'd think it was for a new horror film. It even has a jump scare. Is that a spoiler? Is it possible to spoil a movie trailer? I don't know. It's like if Resident Evil crossed with X-Men. Anyway, if you haven't checked it out, do it as soon as you can because it looks awesome and scary, but still awesome. From sci-fi to horror sci-fi to crude cartoon comedy, South Park The Fractured Butthole Season Pass DLC details have been released by Ubisoft. Grabbing the Season Pass entitles you to costumes and perks from the original South Park RPG Stick of Truth, as well as game tips from everyone's favorite talking towel, Tally. There's also Dr. Timothy's Danger Deck, where players face the ultimate combat challenge. We'll get new story missions called From Dusk Till Casa Bonita and Bring the Crunch, which also introduces a new superhero class to the game. The Season Pass can be picked up for $30 on October 17th, and it's also included as part of the Golden Edition Fractured Butthole pre-order. The individual DLC can be downloaded if you don't feel like getting the butthole thing at once. That's your daily fix for October 13th. Now that you're caught up on the news, let's get this Friday the 13th nice and scary by checking out our review of The Evil Within 2. Is it effortlessly creepy or a terrifying flop? With that, I'm Naomi Kyle, wishing you a killer weekend. Don't forget to download the IGN app, and remember, you can get your fix anytime online at IGN.